Hey, well, thanks for joining us on this Facebook Live at the height of this border crisis and nobody really doing anything to address it here in Washington. I'm RJ Hauman, head of federal government affairs here at FAIR. This is Preston Huennekens, another member of my team here in Washington as we're trying to make sure Congress addresses the crisis and what's going on. Again, everybody knows what's going on down at the southern border. Last month, we had an increase in 32% over the prior month. Nearly 150,000 people apprehended. We're on track for 1 million people crossing our border this fiscal year. It's an absolute crisis. Why is it a crisis? Again, people exploiting our asylum laws. People down in Central American countries know if they make a journey up through Mexico, they can cross our border, get detained for a limited time, and then get released into the interior of the country as we take years to process their cases. Obviously, President Trump is doing all that he can, made a fantastic deal with Mexico, who seems to be doing a great job down there in stopping people coming up through their country and coming to our borders. A much better job than Congress is doing. So what is Congress doing? We've asked many of you to take action on our Phone the Action grassroots page, urging your senators, no amnesty, take action to address the crisis. A big important markup, which is considering a bill in committee, was supposed to happen today in the Senate Judiciary Committee. Lindsey Graham introduced a bill called the Secure and Protect Act that would address some of the asylum laws that are driving the crisis. The bill wasn't as strong as we thought it would be, but he ended that effort. He wants to make a bipartisan deal with Senator Dick Durbin, who's another pro-amnesty person, the leader of the Democrats on his committee. So over the next couple weeks, we'll be putting information out there encouraging you to take action, to contact your senators and tell them address the crisis at the border and no amnesty. But again, Congress actually did do something. They passed at the committee level, they passed a supplemental border funding bill, but it doesn't do much to address the crisis, even though Senator McConnell and other people will say otherwise. Preston, go into this a little bit for the people out there as they see coverage. You know, you're gonna see a lot of coverage out there that, oh, Congress is about to throw 4.5 or so billion at this border crisis. You may think that is a good thing. You may think that will make a difference, but it will not. Preston, talk about what the administration did to kind of get this request and what the Senate's doing.
So originally, the administration had requested about $5 billion worth of funds to address just basic necessities at the border. You know, more beds to detain people that have presented themselves to Border Patrol. Food, medicine, things that people desperately need. And it was generally seen as a very, you know, non-controversial request. But of course, this gets watered down even at the Senate level. Senate Republicans watered this down. They took out all of the provisions giving ICE additional detention capabilities. And so now we have this bill that's about $4.5 billion, but it includes a lot of that stuff, you know, medicine, food, basic ways to repay the Defense Department for stuff they've done. But none of this actually addresses the root cause of the issue. It doesn't change asylum law at all. It doesn't raise the credible fear standard. There's nothing in this bill that is going to solve the crisis. This is just a Band-Aid solution.
Yeah, again, it's the most disappointing thing here that we're seeing as well is we're going to have negotiations. The House may pass a bill that does a similar thing. It's going to look different than the Senate one. You're already seeing Democrats try to put in language in there that undermines the president's enforcement agenda and weakens current law. But this thing that the Senate, you know, Republicans, again, we're a nonpartisan organization, but if there is one party that is a little bit more in line with us on this issue, that cares about enforcement a little bit more and a little less about amnesty than Democrats do, it's Republicans. But if this is the offer, Preston, that came out of the Republican committee, if this is our starting negotiating point with Democrats, you think we're in rough shape, right?
It's only going to get worse, and there's no real reason to think that this is going to get better when they conference with Democrats with their bill.
Yeah, and, absolutely.
You know, we're already hearing that there might be, you know, some very controversial, you know, kind of poison pills in the Democratic House version that when they come to conference, you know, it's unsure how many of those are going to be left out.
Right. You know, we wish they were at a stronger negotiating point again. And one of the main points, again, people have to understand out there, and we're not saying you shouldn't treat people that come up here and exploit some of our laws and get in through our loopholes. They should be treated badly in any sense. No, I think money is needed for humanitarian purposes down there. But if you really, really want to address this crisis, you got to shut off the flow. You make sure these people aren't making the treacherous journey up through Mexico, where they're working with smugglers, cartels, and things like that, to come into our country where they get processed and then released. If anything, when you improve the people's experience and the logistics down there, make things move quicker and easier for these people, you know, you're actually making the business better for these traffickers, smugglers, and cartels. You're encouraging even more people to come up. It's going to be an easier effort. We'll take better care of you. But again, what we need to do is you do the TVPRA, the Flores settlement, these big asylum loopholes that are driving the crisis. There seems to be little appetite up here in Washington to address those things. But again, everybody out there, stay tuned to Fair's Government Relations Team, our front page, fairus.org, Facebook, Twitter, everything like that. We will give you ways to be engaged over the next couple weeks. I know a lot of people will be taking vacation and everything for the 4th of July time, as will people up here in Washington. It's a 4th of July recess. Congress will be out. But behind the scenes up here, Lindsey Graham and his crew will be trying to do, as they say, a bipartisan asylum deal. And anything bipartisan, they say bipartisan, when it relates to immigration, could contain amnesty. And amnesty will not address the crisis. In fact, it will send a message down to Central America and the rest of the world. Hey, bring your children here. Come here. You will get legalized down the line. That's going to make things way worse. So stay tuned to us, Preston, me, Heather on our team. We'll keep you informed on what's going on here in Washington and let you know how you can take action. So again, thanks for having us on, and thanks for tuning in, actually. And we'll keep you engaged.